Many people are worried about minhagim, worried about siman, want to make sure they have a good siman. So he brings down over here, minhag tov shelo lishon biyom Rosh Hashanah. It's a good minhag, good custom not to sleep during the day of Rosh Hashanah. Shekhen ne'ema b'shem Yerushalmi man didamich b'resh shata tamich mazaleh. One who sleeps on Rosh Hashanah, his mazal goes to sleep. Whatever that means, of course. So a person has to make sure to try his best not to fall asleep on Rosh Hashanah day. Ve'yoshev batel ve'eno osek b'torah ki yashen damit. So many people think, oh, now I go to sleep, so we'll sit, l'haki balash, we'll sit and talk, we'll sit, play some cards, we'll have some toilet, and it's great, no problem. Omer halacha, mi she'eno lomed Torah, yoshev batel, you're sitting wasting the time, that's worse. You like sleeping, you're worse than sleeping. Because the guy who's sleeping, hazib the guy, he fell asleep, what do you want from him? The guy who's sitting and wasting the time, what's going on? So therefore the right thing to do is to read the Tehillim, as we all know. It's a big anyan to read the Tehillim three times. A person should try his best throughout the Rosh Hashanah to try to read the Tehillim. That's what a person is supposed to be doing on Rosh Hashanah, not sitting and wasting the time. Obviously, to a certain degree, of course, we understand a certain amount of family time, a certain amount of time that you have to spend with people. That's, of course, understandable. But past that, a person should put the rest of the time into Torah to learn. And he says, best, if let's say a person realizes, listen, it's either I'm going to sit up and waste the time, or I'll go to sleep, and then I'll be able to learn a little bit. I'll be able to read a little Tehillim. He says, if that's the case, the Im Rosho Kaved Alav is very tired, he can't really focus too much. Yishan Me'at Ahar Hatzot Hayom, go to sleep a little bit. After Hatzot, wake up, and then right away, Kadesh Yitchazek La'avodat Hashem Yitbarach, this way you'll be able to get up, to learn, or to pray Minha properly. That's, of course, all mutar. That would be better, more preferable than sitting and being Yosheb Batet, sitting and wasting time on Rosh Hashanah. One last halakha in regards to Erev Rosh Hashanah. That is, we all know the famous halakha, person is not allowed to be mechin miyom tov l'chaviro. That's, halakha says, the person is not allowed to prepare from one day of holiday to the next day of holiday. Now usually, it's because Sfekad Yoma. Usually we have Safek, we're not sure if day one is the right day, or day two not is the right day. So usually let's say Sukkot will have same thing. We're not sure if the first day is Sukkot or the second day is Sukkot. So a person is not allowed to prepare from the first day Sukkot to the second day Sukkot. But the halakha says even on Rosh Hashanah, where we all know there's a famous Gemara that says Yoma Arichta, it's really one long day, it's not Sfekad Yoma in essence. However, there's still somewhat of a Sfekad Yoma, and therefore a person may not prepare anything from the first day Rosh Hashanah, which would be Thursday, to Friday, which is the second day Rosh Hashanah. So a person has to make sure that if, let's say, the wife is cooking, she's going to make sure to start her cooking after Senta Kochavim on Thursday night for Friday. Anything that she wants to prepare for Friday, for Thursday night meal, which is going to be the Friday, that's really Friday. In that case, she has to make sure to wait till after Senta Kochavim, and then she could start cooking for the second day.